Hey everyone, welcome to part four of our Vladimir Kush paintings. If this is your first time watching one of them, we just have four prints of the same artist that we find really meaningful. We think his works have spiritual components to them. He calls himself the father of metaphorical realism. And so this is the last one. We're actually in the bathroom of our bedroom. And so that's why the echo is a little bit weird. Like we said, Strickland Buchholz Studio, very low budge. I love this painting so much. Jen didn't want it. She didn't have as much interest in it. She thought it was a little risque, but I just had to have a print of it. I think it's amazing. So I'm going to pan up here, get you a little closer. You can see a pendulum as if it's a clock with a butterfly, and inside the pendulum is a scene of two people looking out over the sunset. And again, the figures here are heteronormative. It doesn't matter that there's two people, it doesn't matter what gender they are. But what is so meaningful to me, what I love about this, is I think this is a synopsis of the Christian faith, that we are all contained in this moment in time. And I love that they're looking at the sunset, because we all love looking at sunsets. And so they're enjoying life while they have it. But this pendulum is going to keep swinging, and their time in the pendulum is going to come to an end. And death is going to come, as it comes for all of us. But the butterfly, and I don't know if this is what the artist meant for it to be, but it's what I interpret it as. The butterfly is a symbol in Christianity of eternity, this idea of transformation in the chrysalis, going from the caterpillar into the butterfly, is this transformation into the spiritual self. And so we use the butterfly as a symbol of resurrection. And so even though our moment in time might come to an end, our faith gives us hope in eternity, that there might be something else. A little note, if you didn't listen to Jen's Easter sermon about butterflies, how many years ago was that? Was that like the second Easter we were here?
I think it was our first Easter we were here.
So it was like Easter 2017 or Easter 2018. We're going to put a link to it in the email. If you haven't listened to that sermon, it's one of my favorites. You've got to listen to the butterfly sermon. So we'll put a link to that sermon if you want to listen to it in the email today. So that's why I love this one. Have you come to like it at all?
I have, yeah. I think it just didn't feel appropriate to hang in our house initially, because
that's why it was relegated.
As you can see, these two folks are
in the nude
without any clothes on. And in fact, it took us, I don't know how long we've had this painting, but my nieces only recently discovered it when they were in our bathroom for some reason, and they were screaming that we had this portrait of naked people in our bathroom. So, but I have come to appreciate it for all the reasons you described, and I think it is really beautiful to think about every moment that we share with loved ones, or just special moments in nature, are really these little tastes of eternity, these little moments that are both temporal in nature, but also speak to this eternal sense of existence and time. So yes,
that's beautiful.
I have come to appreciate this.
Excellent. All right. Well, thanks for taking this art journey with us for these last devotions. If you have seen something else in the paintings, we'd love to hear it.
Yeah, we would.
Yeah. So, our home is your home. Thanks for being part of it. We'll see you next time.